Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Burak Şentürk and I'm very excited to share my first YouTube video with you because over the time I learned a lot from the self-hosting community. Now I want to share what I learned and also continue to learn from you as well. Today we will talk about self-hosting and why it matters and what it is and how can it help you take control of your digital space. Whether you are a completely beginner or someone looking to expand your setup, I hope you will find this helpful. Simply, self-hosting means the running your own services instead of relying on third-party cloud providers. It could be anything from your own website or file sharing services, even running AI applications in your home. Normally, when you are using platforms like Google Drive, ChatGPT, iCloud, Dropbox, your data and your activity stored on the servers of a company. But in the self-hosting, you keep everything on a machine that you control. Now, you might be wondering why you go through the effort for the self-hosting. Well, there are some key reasons. First of all, privacy and data ownership. When you are using a cloud services, companies store, analyze, and even sell insights from your data. But self-hosting gives you full control, no tracking, no hidden collection. The second thing, and I think is most important one, is security and control. With the self-hosting, you decide how your data is stored, who can access it, and what security measures apply. Whether it encrypted storage or VPN protection or firewalls, you can build anything, any system that prioritizes the security needs. The third thing is cost saving. Many cloud services have free tiers, but costs add up while you need some extra storage or extra features. With the self-hosting, you can set up your system with a one-time investment and avoid the recurring fees. And most of the applications are open source and free. The fourth one is performance and customization. Unlike the cloud platforms, you are limited by their settings and their pricing plans. Self-hosting lets you fully customize your setup. You can tweak your settings, optimize your performance, and also automate your systems. One of the best things of the self-hosting is the variety of the applications you can deploy. So you can deploy your personal cloud storage, your media servers in home, share it with your family and friends, private messaging services, password managers, home automation, even you can host your own AI tools at your home with your devices. On the other end, most probably you don't need any expensive hardware in the beginning. You can use your old PC or some cheap Raspberry Pis. They can handle most of that kind of tasks. In next videos, I will show you how to choose right hardware for self-hosting, also building and assembling your own PC servers. And for this, I will disassemble my server and assemble again. And we will install some operating system for virtualization and home lab. You can use many of them. Most of the people using Linux or Proxmox or Windows. Most probably I will go with Windows in the beginning and I will change or install another one to another hardware. So also we will set up some network and security. Then we have a lot of applications to deploy in useful in for our home lab. My goal is make these videos as clear and beginner friendly as possible, and I will love to hear your feedbacks along the way. Maybe self-hosting is not for everyone. It requires some learning, unlike the traditional cloud services. You will be responsible for all updates, maintenance, services, security. But if you enjoy the tinkering with tech, value your privacy, or want to build something truly your own, I think the self-hosting is best for you. If you find my videos helpful and want to follow my journey that building a self-hosted system from scratch, then you may choose to subscribe my channel. In that way, you will be notified when the next video is out. I'm looking forward to learning together, and see you in the next video.